Today we're going to be talking about the signs that your ex is testing you, but really more specifically, I want to look at the specific tests your ex will give you and maybe decipher a little bit about where your ex is at psychologically. Now, let's tackle a big question first. Why would your ex want to test you? There's any number of reasons why they would want to test you, but before I get into the reasons, the first thing you should be doing is figuring out whether or not you even have a chance of getting them back, so you know how to go forward. Now, luckily for you, on my website, www.exboyfriendrecovery.com, I've put together a special quiz designed to answer that very question for you. Now, all you have to do if you want to take the quiz is simply look in the description link below this YouTube video and click on it. It's that simple and straightforward. So, why would an ex want to test you? Well, after working in this business for more than a decade, I've learned that there's really three main reasons for why they would test you. Now, these three main reasons aren't the only reasons they will test you, but they are kind of big factors. So most of the time, if an ex is testing you, it's going to be because of one of these three reasons. So first, you have just morbid curiosity. Essentially, your ex gets curious as to what you're up to or how you'll react to something, so they give you a test. And I'm gonna get to the tests in a minute, but before, let's get some of the psychology down. So we have curiosity. There's not really much to explain other than your ex gets curious as to how you're going to react. The second reason is they go on a power trip. Now, what does this look like? Well, usually, sometimes an ex, especially an ex-boyfriend who you're trying to get back or even trying to get over, will not only get curious, but they'll go an extra step and wonder how you'll react. For example, you often see this with men who are trying to make you jealous. It's almost a way to re-exert power. So we see this a lot of times with women who have actually broken up with their ex-boyfriends, where their exes will basically say, "Hey, look how great my life is without you." It's their way of gaining power back. It's almost like saying, "Look, you broke up with me, but I'm gonna take the power back by basically showing you how great my life is without you." And the third reason an ex would give you a test is essentially to make a decision. So let's say they're determining whether or not they should get back with you or not, or whether or not you're trustworthy again. They'll give you a test to measure your trust or measure your response that will help them make a decision related to you. Now, we've gone through some of the more basic reasons for why exes will test you, but let's actually talk about some of the most common tests that your ex will actually try to give you throughout your breakup. Now, I'm not going to lie. It was actually hard for me to think of more than three tests. I had to dig deep throughout our private Facebook group, and even that wasn't sufficient enough to find tests that I thought were worthy of talking about in this video. In fact, I actually had to go to Google and type in many different random forums to figure out what kind of tests couples give each other in relationships and relay it to what I've seen in my personal coaching calls. And essentially, I boiled down to five main tests that I've seen throughout my decades worth of research. So what I'd like to do right now is go through those tests one by one, explain what they are, and a little bit about the psychology behind someone who would give that test to you. Test number one, the jealousy test. Okay, so I've already alluded to this aspect of a test in my explanation of the reasons behind why exes would give you tests, but I'll reiterate it again. A jealousy test is essentially where an ex will try to make you jealous on purpose to see how you will respond. And there can be any real number of reasons for why they give you this test. Some exes will simply want to brag about how great their life is without you, but this is often an indicator that their life isn't as great as they make it seem, because if their life really was that great without you, they wouldn't be thinking about you or needing to rub your face in it. And then, of course, there's those insecure exes who want to make you jealous because they feel like it's the only way to get your attention. So they'll try to make you jealous by saying some comment in a text message about, like, "Hey, I can't talk to you right now, I'm on a date." Something very obvious to try to get your attention. It's almost like a cry for help. So how do you tell which psychology your ex has during the jealousy test? I actually think probably the best way to explain or determine whether or not your ex is just trying to rub your face in it or whether or not they're trying to get your attention is how obvious the jealousy is. Now, in the example I gave where basically your ex is saying like, hey, sorry, I'm on a date right now, that's a very obvious sign of jealousy. So in other words, that's most likely going to be them trying to rub your face in it. Subtle hints of jealousy happens more on social media, where maybe they take a picture with a group of friends and you see he's got his arm around some girl. He's not rubbing your face in it, but it's also kind of this passive declaration of war. That is often a test to get your attention as well, just in a much more subtle way. It's kind of like saying, I care about your feelings, but I'm also trying to show like, hey, I want you to be bothered by this. Test number two, the ignore test. So this one I actually think is an extension of the no contact rule. So anyone who's actually been to my website, listened to my podcast, or even watched the YouTube videos on my YouTube channel will know that I'm a big fan of the no contact rule. It's one of the most effective strategies that you can use to build the foundation if you want to get your ex back, or even if you just want to get over your ex. But sometimes ex-boyfriends will take this personally, almost as if you're being childish about the breakup, and their response is actually the most childish of all. So one thing that I'm a little bit different than my peers in is how you respond after the no contact rule. So a lot of people will just say, go in no contact until your ex contacts you. My whole approach is go in no contact for this time frame that we've set that seems to work, and then after that, reach out to your ex and control sort of the text message conversation, but end it first. So when the no contact rule is over and you actually do end up reaching out to your ex, sometimes you won't get a response from your ex. And if you try this a couple of times and don't get a bite, oftentimes this is a test from your ex. They're basically letting it known through their inaction that I'm very upset about the fact that you used the no contact rule on me, so I'm going to ignore you too. It's kind of like, well, you did this to me, so I'm gonna do this back to you. Now, it is an immature way to approach the relationship, but I guess they can argue morally that it was immature for you to go in a no contact rule. What's important to remember here is it's more of a don't panic type of a situation. Usually just time will solve this, and eventually they'll kind of get curious as to what you're up to. So it's kind of like a situation of playing chicken. Who can stick to their guns longer? Test number three, the sex test. Okay. Now this one is actually pretty interesting because it has different connotations on whether it comes from a man or a woman. Now I'm making this video mostly for females because they're most of the people who actually watch my videos, and also this video will be posted within ex-boyfriend recovery. So I'm going to tell you first how men give you the sex test. And then after that, I'll tell you how women give you the sex test. Okay. So here's how the sex test works. You and your ex are talking back and forth and things seem to be going extremely well when all of a sudden you begin to flirt a little bit and your ex tries to turn the conversation sexually. Now, eventually you just flirt back when they turn the conversation to sex, and let's say the conversation ends, but then every conversation thereafter always ends up turning to sex in some way, shape, or form. Now, men are often doing this to fish to see if you're open to sleeping with them again and entering into a friends with benefits situation. And unfortunately, a lot of women are under this false pretense that they need to sleep with their ex to get their ex back. It's almost like they think sometimes that if they don't sleep with their ex, the ex isn't going to come back, and maybe that sleeping with the ex, maybe that having sex with them is the act that actually pushes them over the edge and makes them commit. And more often than not, I tell them that's not ever the case, and they come back to me and say, you are right, now I'm in a friends with benefits scenario. So that's how men give you the sex test. Women, on the other hand, will give their ex-boyfriends the sex test in the opposite way. They'll try to maybe make some type of flirty comment, but they're testing to see if their guy is only wanting sex. So in this odd way, you have kind of a similar reaction throughout the sex test, just for different reasons. Test number four, the emotional support test. Now, I think when it comes to this emotional support test, the one thing that you really need to look for is the timing of when it occurs, but I'll get to that in a minute. So what is the emotional support test? Well, essentially, it's where your ex opens up to you in a very emotional way, seeking emotional support from you. And this test can go either way. So sometimes your ex will do this immediately off the bat because they liked the emotional support that you provided while you were in the relationship. It's just they want to also play the field too. So they kind of want to get the emotional support from you and maybe the physical benefits from someone else. Now, usually when they're seeking that kind of a relationship, it's happening at the beginning of the no contact rule, or at the beginning of when the no contact rule has been complete and you get back in touch with them. But let's say you've been talking back and forth for 3 months and things are going great, but there's been no emotional support needs from his part until maybe 3 months out and he starts talking about it all of a sudden. This is an interesting thing because it is definitely a test to see if things will be kind of cool if you can offer that emotional support and how he'll feel about it. My best rule of thumb here is to look at when your ex is seeking the emotional support. If it's at the beginning of when you start communicating with them again after the breakup, usually provide enough that is beneficial but not going to go above and beyond. The goal here isn't to be rude to your ex, it's maybe to not just give them the benefits of being in a relationship with you. But if your ex does ask for emotional support or starts talking about a death in the family or things of that nature that you really wouldn't talk about with a stranger or even just a friend, and it's maybe like 4 or 5 months after you've been talking, that's a good sign because it kind of is a sign that they're looking and maybe reminiscing about some of the really cool aspects of your relationship. Test number 5, the career test. Now, I am going to be completely honest with you. When I actually decided to make this video, I wanted to make this video where I at least had 5 different tests that I could bring to the table and show you guys. The problem is I was making the video for women and I could only find 4 tests that I would find that really men would exhibit a lot. There was a 5th test that I've noticed women exhibit on their ex-boyfriend. So while I think it's highly unlikely that an ex-boyfriend would exhibit this test on a woman, I feel it is still kind of an important thing to know just in the grand scheme of things. So let's say that you're a guy and you're trying to get your ex-girlfriend back. One of the tests that the ex-girlfriend may give you is the career test. Essentially, one of the things that women do look for in men is a stable type of a career or some type of aspirations that is going to have them out of mommy and daddy's house. You know, they want a man that can provide for himself. So they'll ask them different questions about how life has been going. They're gonna really fish for what his career aspirations are. And this is especially important for men who have been in long-term relationships where this was a huge killing point of the relationship. So it's something you need to keep an eye out for. And one of the things that I always tell men when it comes to the no contact rule is get your holy trinity in act: health, wealth, and relationships. So oftentimes men are really good at the health aspect. They start lifting weights, they start losing weight, they start trying to get in really good shape, but they really kind of suck at the wealth aspect, meaning they kind of just take it for granted and forget completely about it. But it's something you definitely need to work on. And I think women can take this advice as well. Women tend to be really good at the relationships side of things, you know, making new friends, getting back in touch with old family members, and they tend to be really, really good at health as well, in my opinion. They tend to kind of put wealth by the wayside, but I think it's kind of an important thing to look at because one of the big factors we're noticing really helps when it comes to getting an ex back is essentially letting go of an ex or finding something that you can prioritize above that ex. And sometimes looking at a career can help you do that. Hey there, thank you so much for getting to the end of this video. Again, if you haven't already, make sure you take that quiz that I was talking about at the beginning of the video. All you have to do is simply look in the description link below this YouTube video and click on it, and you can figure out kind of what chance you have of getting your ex back. Also, if you haven't liked, commented, or subscribed to the YouTube channel, please do so. Every little bit helps. I'll see you next time.